Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is one that has been very highly requested by a bunch of different people every time I've mentioned learning to code or designing or building a website in a vlog or a video. You've been telling me to try out Webflow. It's become a very popular tool these days, it seems. If you haven't heard of it, if you're not one of those people who've been telling me to try it out, it's basically a design slash development tool, software, whatever you want to call it, for creating websites. It's a drag and drop editor for making a website, so you don't have to code it. I've never personally been interested in using one of these website building tools before because they notoriously give out really bad code, like bloated, and which makes your site run slower and it's harder to edit again later. But Webflow has a really good reputation. I decided to try it out because Mackenzie Child, who is a designer slash developer here on YouTube who makes really good stuff, you should definitely subscribe to him. He'll be linked on a card up there. But he mentioned Webflow and said that he was pleasantly surprised at the quality of code it produces. And so that definitely got me interested in trying it. In this video right here right now, I'm going to be using it for the first time. I've not actually dived in yet because I wanted to be able to film a first impressions video and tell you my thoughts as I go along. I have a design that I've created in Sketch for my pricing course that by the time you see this video will have gone live. So this right here is what I'll be attempting to build in Webflow. Pretty basic, pretty simple, but I think it'll be a good place for me to start getting the feel for it and seeing what it's like to use the software and tell you my opinions on it. Now, I will say that I have watched a few tutorials for using Webflow on their website so that I am kind of familiar with where to click or whatever when I dive into it, and I found them really useful. So if you're looking to get started using Webflow, then I would definitely recommend checking them out. They'll be linked down below in the description. But enough intro, let's get into attempting to build this page using Webflow. So this is the dashboard on Webflow, and I'm going to click New Project and get started. I'm going to get started by adding a section, comes first, I suppose, and then a container to it. What I really liked when I was watching the tutorials, and I can see it in here now, is that it seems like Webflow just takes regular HTML and CSS things and makes it visual. So I recognize all of these options here as things that I would write in code, but instead obviously I'm just gonna put them in these places. And that's definitely what makes me trust it and trust the code that comes out of it, because I'm not, for example, able to drag that div block that I just put in anywhere on the screen. I put it, you know, where it went, and now I'm gonna have to set the width of it myself, which is what you would have to do in code. I'm gonna refer to my design every now and then as well for this, just so you know. So I've used a bootstrap grid for my design because that's just what I've always tended to use. So now I've got to work out how to work with the columns and things within Webflow. I don't know if they do flexbox or something like that. That might be what these columns are. Ah, yes, it does seem to be that. There we go. Right, so now I'm going to add in my heading, I suppose. Let's see what that does. The font I've used in my design is a Google font, and I assumed that I would be able to access it through here. There must be a way to do that, but I do not currently know it, so I'm just going to go with this one for now. It is pretty nice just being able to click in all these text options here and, you know, basically have it coded for you. I like this option. When I tick it, it knows that I've uploaded a 2x version, so it's going to like put it half the size so it shows nicely on Retina screens. My only problem is that I cannot see this image because it is white. And centering is apparently not a thing I can do on the image. Let's see somehow if I can edit this class. The thing is, if this was code, I know that centering in this column here would do it all, so let's try that, I guess. If I tick this, is that gonna put, yes, put the image in the middle. Okay, so I think you kind of need to, well, so far it seems anyway, have an understanding, basic understanding of code to use this properly. I like that this has defaults in place to start with, because obviously if I'm putting in paragraph text, it's put like a common size and style for a piece of, like, you know, a long piece of text. which is really cool, and then I can just edit it from there. Rather than having to create that style from scratch, I guess that just saves a little bit of time. Okay, so my form. Obviously, because I work for ConvertKit, in case you didn't know, which is an email marketing software company, I'm gonna be using ConvertKit for my form, but for now I'm just gonna drag this guy in and see what happens with it. So I want you in this column. What have I done? Okay, so this is gonna take a bit of styling work, it seems. Don't want that label there, so can I just delete that? Nice. I've now decided that I want to put all of this in a div because I think that that will help. I'll be able to change the padding and things easier. So I wonder if I can just grab a div block and... Nope, not like that. It's strange that I can't pick things up after I've put it down, if that makes sense. All of you Webflow experts out there are going to be thinking I'm doing this really wrong, aren't you? But anyway. Just jumped ahead a bit because my battery needed to charge. I've not had much luck working out how to change the style, like the color of this text here, because it says white, but it's not. So I need to Google that. But I've discovered this tab component in here, which I am going to use for, if I open up my design, for this bit here, because this is where I'm gonna embed the YouTube video, and then you're gonna click through and it'll load a new one in the place. And I thought I might have to do this like adapting a carousel or something weird, but this is very handy. I've just been able to create some tabs. So I'm currently styling these buttons. Seems like you should just be able to put in a YouTube link to embed a video, so let's try that. Yes, that worked out very well. I don't know if it's my Chrome or what, but it seems to be having trouble adding things to the bottom of the page. Well, as you can see, I've got all the basic stuff in. I'm not quite sure how to create these sharing icons best yet. I need to do a bit of research into that, but I've just got some buttons in the place for now. All in all, that was really fast and easy to build. Quite excited about that. Still a few issues, like these text fields here that I'm not quite sure about, and like I said, these buttons, but for the most part, this is the bones of my site. Now, I haven't looked yet at the mobile options, so time to click through and see what that's doing. So, on tablet. Nice, nice. Is it going to be like using the column options in Bootstrap, where it'll only affect it from here down? No, it has not done that. Okay, so that doesn't work as I was expecting. All in all, this adapts pretty well. This is interesting. I'm not quite sure what it's doing here, but I know that on mobile I don't want these giant gaps in the way, so what can I do about that? Ah, I see. So those things were only showing in the editing window, and actually when they're not there, it's absolutely fine, so that's great. Okay, I think I'm going to stop here for now because this is a really good start, and I will Google to help me with these final things. That was really easy. I'm quite impressed. I said that several times now, haven't I? This is what it looks like on desktop. So like I said, there's just those form field options, and I need to fill in the content for these tabs because currently there's only a video in the first one, but it's amazing that it just already works like that, so that's good. And this is gonna link out to YouTube. I need to put that link in. Need to work out these icons, but for the most part, this looks pretty similar to the design that I created. I was able to put things where I wanted them, and it's already like following the styling for the different devices as well, which is incredibly handy because that's much less work, isn't it, for me. There are some things that didn't work like I expected. For example, I'm still confused about this form field. I'm sure it's a really simple answer and I've just not worked it out, but anyway. And some things, like it seems at the bottom of the screen it was getting confused, like you saw. It is drag and drop from the menu at the side, but if you try and arrange stuff within here, you can't actually click and drag them, it seems. You got to do it in this layers panel at the side here. Overall, very happy with it, and we'll definitely be using it again. Next step for me, obviously, is to finish this off and then export the code and have it hosted on my own website with my own URL, etc. Skipping forward a little bit into the future, I just wanted to insert this clip and show you what the page ended up looking like. So this is it live on my site. As you can see, I got this placeholder text sorted out. In the end, I had to talk to the Webflow team about it to get help on that. It seemed like a known issue, and they were able to help me. Basically, I had to insert this inline styles in here. To use the code for the site, I used this option here, which is exports the code. So it downloads a zip file with the HTML, the CSS, and the assets that you've used in the code as well, which is very handy. And then I was able to just make that essentially into a WordPress page by putting a blank header and a blank footer on it that I created especially. So that was a good way around it of getting to use that on WordPress. I know that Webflow does have some publishing options, but I obviously wanted to integrate this with the rest of my site, so that's how I chose to do it. I'm glad that it did that because it got me to dive in and take a bit of a closer look at the code itself as well. As you can see, it looks pretty normal. Obviously, I'm no expert with code, but it looks pretty good to me. There is a lot of classes on these columns though, for example, but anyway. One thing I do wish it did more was encourage me to use classes in the way I would if I was coding, because I feel like that would have been a help. I ended up for some reason having classes on links that I don't think should really be necessary. I should have just been able to edit the A tag within the block that I had that in. So I'm not sure what happened there, but obviously this is all a learning curve and probably that's not necessary. This is obviously something that I will learn from and be able to do better next time. All in all though, very impressed, and it's definitely the best website builder tool that I've used. Anyway, back to past Charlie. I really hope you've enjoyed seeing my first impression of Webflow, especially if you're one of the people who has been telling me to try it for a long time. So thank you for suggesting it. I'm really glad I tried it and will definitely be using it again. If you'd like to check out this website that I have been creating in this video, then the link will be here. I can't remember what I said the URL was going to be for it right now. Thank you for watching this video. Please give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it and enjoyed seeing me try it. There's some more software that I've not tried yet that I could do a first impression of. Like Adobe XD springs to mind is one that people have been saying I should try for a while. So if you'd like to see that, let me know as well. If you've used Webflow, let me know what you think of it down below in the comments. If you've got any tips for me, then that would be much appreciated. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a good day, and I will see you next time. Bye.